Oh, I do apologize for my appearance, by the way. I've seen me, I know. And I get it. I got a haircut recently. Obviously not a good one. I don't know what I'm doing. And I go in there and the lady's like, well, what do you want? And I said, well, I'd like to look a little more like Andy. And apparently what she hears is I'd like to look like little orphan Annie. So I'm stuck with this crap for a while. This is awesome. Some lady asked me the other day, she's like, do you perm your hair? Yeah. Yeah, that's just what this needed is a perm. I remember looking in the mirror going, what would offset this annoying? Yeah, perm, that'll be good. Let's get a perm. Perm it up. Perm. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and bleach these eyebrows while I'm at it. I don't have anything to do on the weekends. By the way, if you are born with these lovely white eyebrows, and per my research, almost nobody else is, this is just a sign that one day you'll be a mall Santa right there. That's what that is. Unbelievable. Oh, man. I never know what to wear when I do comedy. They always say you should wear something that makes you feel comfortable, but I figure you folks didn't want to see me in a feather boa and a thong either, so I went with this slimming ensemble. Yeah. It's the weirdest case of Tourette's I've ever heard in my life. I thought about wearing my Halloween costume. I have the scariest Halloween costume. I go as Winnie the Pooh. Think about it. What's creepier than me showing up to your front door wearing only a red half shirt? Carrying a pot of honey? Singing some Rob Zombie? Pretty creepy, I would know. I've seen me naked. You seem like a big Rob Zombie fan, right, ma'am? I can tell by looking at you. Come on, sing along with me. You'll know it when you hear it. You ready? Dig through the ditches and burn through the witches. And so you don't seem to know that one. All right. You're more of a Slipknot fan. I can tell you're big into Slipknot. You know Slipknot. They're like the heavy metal group. They all wear masks. They're kind of like the Wu-Tang Clan. They have way too many members in the group, you know? They got three drummers. One of them is a clown who plays a baseball bat on a metal keg. I'm not making that up at all, but you know this. You're a fan. Come on, sing along with me. You ready? If you're 5'5", then I'm 6'6". You don't know that one either. All right. Five Finger Death Punch. Everybody likes Five Finger Death Punch. That lady right there's got a whole back tattoo she was showing off earlier, Five Finger Death Punch, in the lobby. We were like, man, it's a family show, sort of, yeah. Come on, sing along with me. You'll know this one for sure. You ready? Oh, there's a demon in... You don't know that one either. All right. We're going to find an angry song we can bond over later, maybe like some Carpenters or Kenny G or something like that, something really evil. You know Kenny G's evil. Nobody should play that much flugelhorn or saxophone or whatever the hell that thing is. World's filthiest clarinet, Kenny G. I don't know. By the way, Kenny G is the music they play at the beginning of every seance, so if you hear that music, run for it. Unless that's what you're into, and you're like, hail Satan, let's do this. I brought a goat. That's my new catchphrase. I just like to walk into places going, I brought a goat. They're like, this is the dentist's office, sir. I'm real sorry about that, ma'am. I heard that Kenny G music. I didn't know what was going on in here. I figured we were either cleaning teeth or summoning the devil, one or the other. I got a cavity, hurts like hell. Let's do both. Come on. Oh, my God. I appreciate it. You don't. They're not going to be able to use that. All right. I'm an idiot. I'm real sorry about that. Ugh.